In this video, we will be discussing the formatting options found in Microsoft Excel. We will be working with a file which can be found at this web address. The file contains a list of college courses, textbooks, and prices. When we look at the ISBN column in Excel, it shows the number with scientific notation in some of the cells because the cells are too narrow. We can fix this by resizing the column. We can resize the column by moving our mouse between the column labels, waiting for the cursor to turn into a vertical bar with horizontal arrows, and dragging the edge of the column. We can also have the column resize itself to an appropriate size by simply double-clicking between the column labels. You may notice that we lost the leading zero in most of our ISBNs. Only one ISBN did not lose the leading zero because that ISBN contained the letter X and was treated as text. In all other cases, the ISBNs were treated as numbers and the leading zero was dropped. If you look at the top of the home ribbon, there is a number format drop-down box showing the word general. This indicates that this cell is currently formatted as a general data type, which means that Excel will attempt to pick the best format for the data. In our case, we want the cell to be formatted as text, so the leading zero is not lost. Notice that when we re-enter the leading zero, Excel now shows us a warning message indicating that the number in this cell is formatted as text or preceded by an apostrophe. We can click on the drop-down arrow next to the warning exclamation mark and tell Excel to ignore this error. Another way that we can make sure that Excel shows our leading zeros is preceding the leading zero with an apostrophe. This indicates that the contents of the cell following the apostrophe will be treated as text even though the cell still has a general format. When we enter text that exceeds the size of the cell, the text will appear to overflow into other cells unless those adjacent cells are filled with content. We can resize the cell to show all of the text, or we can have Excel word wrap the cell by clicking on Wrap Text in the Home ribbon. We have two columns in our spreadsheet containing dollar amounts. When we look at the number format drop-down in the Home ribbon, we can see that there are two ways we can format cells containing money. To see the difference, let's select currency for the first cell of the wholesale column and accounting for the first cell of the retail column. Notice how the dollar sign in the currency format is positioned right next to the number, while in the accounting format, the dollar sign is spaced away from the number. If we resize the column, we find that with the accounting format, the dollar is always as far left in the cell as possible. Another way we can quickly access the accounting format is by clicking on the dollar sign in the home ribbon. Accounting format allows the columns and dollar signs in different cells to line up with each other. You may notice that some of the numbers in this column have different levels of decimal precision. We can click on Increase Decimal Places in the Home ribbon to increase the number of places shown to the right of the decimal point. However, our numbers are still not lining up with the accounting formatted cells at the top. If we only want to show the dollar sign for the first row, we can click on the comma style icon in the Home ribbon, and our columns will line up because this icon applies the accounting format, but without currency symbols. Let's add a couple of columns. First, we'll add a quantity column and fill in some numbers. Then we will add a cost column that will be our quantity multiplied by wholesale price. We will enter the equal sign, select the quantity cell, enter an asterisk for multiplication, and select the wholesale cell. We can use the fill handle to fill the entire column with this calculation. We can then select the new cells and click on comma style, so the cells are formatted in accounting format, but without the currency symbol. Let's select our data and move it towards the center of the spreadsheet. I know I am moving the cells when I drag the selection because the mouse cursor is changed to a black four-headed arrow with a white pointer cursor. Do you notice that some of the values in the cost column have been replaced by number signs? This means that the column is too small for the data that it contains. If we adjust the column, the number signs will disappear, and we will see our numbers again. Our columns are all different sizes, but we can quickly and easily adjust that by holding down the Control key while pressing A to select the entire spreadsheet, and then double-clicking between any two columns, adjusting all of the columns simultaneously. We can add a row of totals using the Auto Sum button to sum our columns. Auto Sum creates a formula using the sum function, predicting what cells we want to total. Let's add some borders to make the data a little clearer, separating the headings and totals from the data. Selecting the heading row of cells, we can click on the border icon in the home ribbon, giving the cells a bottom border. Selecting the totals row of cells, we can click on the drop-down arrow next to the border icon and select a top and double bottom border. Let's say we want to add a large title at the top of the spreadsheet. We can select multiple cells and click on Merge and Center in the Home ribbon. This combines multiple cells into one cell with centered text. If we wanted to unmerge these cells later, we can click on the drop-down and select Unmerge. Let's add some text and apply some text formatting. We can go into more detailed formatting options by right-clicking on the cell and selecting Format Cells. This allows us to specify exactly how we want our data to appear. We might want to add conditional formatting, such as drawing attention to any orders containing more than 40 of a specific book. We can do this by selecting a cell, clicking on Conditional Formatting drop-down in the Home ribbon, and then selecting a Highlight Cells rule, highlighting cells that are greater than 40. If we were to use the fill handle to propagate these changes to their cells, we would be replacing the data in those cells. We definitely do not want to lose our data, so instead of using the fill handle, we can use the Format Painter to apply this format to our other cells. First, we select the cell containing the format we want to use. Then, we click on Format Painter in the Home ribbon. We select the cells we wish to apply the format to, and the format is copied to those cells without altering the data in those cells. Another interesting feature we can find under Conditional Formatting is the Data Bars feature, which shows a miniature bar in the background of the cell, showing the value of the cell in comparison to other cells. Finally, let's say we do not like the formatting we've created so far, and we just want to start over. But we do not want to lose our data in our formulas. We can select our entire spreadsheet, again by pressing Ctrl and A, and click on the Clear drop-down in the Home ribbon, and select Clear Formats. This removes all of the formatting, but without removing any of the formulas or data. If we wanted to, we could apply clear formatting to just a single cell instead of all of our spreadsheet.